This video shows you the basic process and how to draw an isometric drawing from a component. First thing that you need to do with your component is to measure it up. What we're going to do is we're going to draw an isometric box. So we need to know the length, the height, and the width of the component so that when we draw our box, we draw it to those sizes. Now with an isometric drawing, all the horizontal lines are at 30 degrees, so that's 30 degrees from the horizontal. All your vertical lines are absolutely vertical, straight up and down. So you need to keep that in mind when you're drawing your isometric box. Have all your verticals vertical, have all your horizontal lines at 30 degrees from the horizontal.
Don't go away.
And you can see how it's looking when we draw the box. Now when we draw the box, we're just drawing it in pencil. We're drawing it quite lightly so that, because we have to rub it out afterwards. And so it's part of our construction lines. Once we've drawn the box, we start to draw the edges of the component in it. So we've measured the thickness of the material, and now we're starting to draw in the actual shape of the component. So you can see the basic shape taking place. Basically, we have an L-shaped component, the thickness of about 10 millimeters. You can see now how we've drawn that in the box. We need to draw the box as if you can see straight through it. So what's happening now is we're drawing the back edges of the original box. This helps us to draw our component in there. Now I'm drawing the component in there straight without any curves on it. We'll put the curves and the radiuses on it later. Now what I'm doing is measuring that cut-off piece. I'm measuring the width of it and the length of it, and I'm then going to mark that on the box. If you simply use the measurements that you have taken, mark it off, and then draw a line between those two points, that will be the cutoff piece. Of course I have to do the top edge and also the bottom edge. Now you can draw your part to size, or you can scale it up or down. So if you have a large component and you want to draw it smaller, then you scale it down. If you have a small component and you want a larger picture, you scale it up. I now just measured the centre of the hole, and so again on our drawing we're using the exact same measurements to get the centre of the hole. Now I'm just drawing some center lines in there, which will help me when I have to draw my isometric circle. An isometric circle is a little difficult to draw. There are certain ways that you can do it when you're drawing it properly on an engineering drawing, and that it is described in the material and the content, the competency. And so you can do that if you wish. For this exercise you don't need to do that, but you do need to get it to look like an isometric circle. An isometric circle is not going to be round, it's going to be oval shape. And so what I'm doing here is I'm simply by marking out the whole diameter and then drawing an oval type shape until it looks similar to what's on the actual component. And of course you need to draw in the back edge of it, because the material is only 10mm thick, you actually can see the back edge of that hole. Likewise with the radiuses, there are special ways to do that for a proper isometric circle or curve, and again it shows you how to do that in the course material. Once you have finished it in pencil, I'm now just going over it with a black texter, marking just the actual shape of the component. And you can see it materialise in front of me. I'm just going straight over the pencil lines that we've previously drawn. It's drawn completely in pencil first so that we can rub out the mistakes. Make sure you get that you draw in all the edges and the holes and the radiuses. And you can see there we have it. There we have a basic sketch, an isometric sketch of my component. I'm now rubbing out the construction lines. So I'm rubbing out all the pencil lines that I don't need. This will help clarify the actual component and make it easier to see. Even though the lines are in pencil, sometimes that can be distracting. And there we have it, there we have an isometric sketch of the real component. Now what I'm doing, and you must do the same, is to dimension it. When dimensioning an isometric, your extension lines come off at the same angle as the edges, as the surfaces that you are trying to dimension. So we do the extension lines, then we do our dimension lines, making sure that we put a little arrow on there, and then write in our dimension. And you need to make sure then that all the sizes are dimensioned on your component. Again, making sure to keep the extension lines and the dimension lines at the same angles as the edge or surface you're dimensioning on the component. You also have to make sure that you dimension any holes just by using your normal hole type dimensioning, and also any radiuses. You can't make the part unless you know all those dimensions, so those dimensions need to be on the drawing. So there we have it. An isometric drawing by using a real component, fully dimensioned, ready for use.